Hello, and welcome back to my garage. Today we have a Skoda Fabia. This, of course, isn't a stranger on the channel. We had it before. I do think it is a well now ago, but enfin. It didn't pass the annual safety check, and that's the reason why it is here. It needs 4 new tires. Well, that's something that isn't too fun to watch, so we're not going to, well, make a video about that. But the other thing is a CV joint boot. Of course, I have did it before, but I do think this is a bit different than the other videos. Normally, I would use a boot that is fitted for the car, so not a universal one that is this one. Also, this is a stretch boot. Why is it a stretch boot? Well, because we are going to stretch it on the shaft, so we don't have to remove the CV joint itself. If you have a little bit of experience with removing CV joints, that can be a little bit of a hassle. I really struggle with them all the time. Sometimes it's easy, other times it's just a big hassle. And that is why stretch boots are really handy. But if you want to use a stretch boot, of course, you can still remove the CV joint, use it as you please, no problem. But of course, this is a stretch boot, and why won't we use it as it is intended? Stretch it on the shaft. So there are two kinds of tools on the market. One is a cone. I do have one of these cones, but I cannot find it. And to be honest, I used it in the past, and it is a nightmare to use. I find it a nightmare to use. Most of the time I just rip up the boots. So those cones are, well, the principle is quite easy. What you do, put the cone on the CV joint, loop up the cone as good as you can, get your boot. In this case, you have to, well, fold it inside out. If you don't do that, then it is the wrong way around. And what you have to do then is just push it on the cone until it stretches over it, and then it pops out on the other side. Like I said, I did use it in the past. I was definitely not a fan of that. I'd rather remove the CV joint itself. The other tool, of course, it's a little bit more expensive, is a stretch tool. This is a pneumatic one. I do only think they make pneumatic ones. I don't know for sure, but I do think so. And what it is, well, quite easy. Push the button, it opens. Other button releases the pressure, and it closes again. Yeah, I know, you can do some freaky stuff with this thing. So I will show you how to use one of these, well, boot guns, or how you want to call it, stretcher. Because we have to do a wheel side boot, we don't have to turn it inside out, because we are going to put it on this. Push the button, it slides over it, and of course we can put it into its place. If you want to replace a inner boot, or an inner boot from, well, the gearbox side, you have to, of course, put it inside out, put it in there, stretch it. If it is on the shaft, then you can put it the right side around, and of course it is then the correct way on the shaft. The first times I used this thing, it just stretched up this rubber to a point that it's not going back to its original form. The reason, of course, is always quite simple. You put it on the gun, you press the button, it stretches, but because it is rubber, and rubber, or, well, silicon or something, this of course has grip. It grips on the teeth, and what will happen is that the stretch is not evenly distributed on the, well, the whole thing. So it wants to stretch one part more, and that's why it loses its properties to, well, come back to its normal shape. So my advice is, before you put it on the gun, you can do two things. One is grease up the, well, the teeth here. But what I like to do is put some silicone inside here and then push it on there. But of course, I cannot find my silicone spray and I do think I am running out, or that I have run out. So what I will do is I use a little bit of grease that is, well, needed of course inside this. So I will loop it up a bit and then use the gun. Of course, it's going to be a little bit more of a mess, but oh well, you have to do with stuff you got. Tip number two, what I did in the past is, if you used a universal, well, CV boot before, in my experience, that says one size fits none. And that is awfully the case. But what to do is, you can cut this off. So if you need a little bit smaller, then you cut it here. If you need it still a bit smaller, you can cut it here. And if you want to even smaller, then you cut it here. What I did do in the past is just look first where, oh yeah, I have to cut it here. What I did was cut it, and then, but what happens, because you are going to cut it, and most of the time we're not that precise, you open the boot, it rips, because you have, well, a little torn in it. So don't cut it before installing it on the car. If you're trying this for the first time, if it is with a cone or with this thing, be sure you have another, because you are definitely going to destroy one of these. I've got a box full of them. Like I said, I don't use them that often because, yeah, I don't really like it to do it. But I was a bit of a pinch. I had ordered a correct one for the car, but the order still hasn't shipped yet. I do have the tires, but I don't have the parts. So yeah, I'm a bit of a pinch, and that's why these are really handy. So I always have a couple of these in the shop. And also, I thought this is a good opportunity to show you how this works. Maybe I do know where that cone is. I still don't know where that cone is. So let me show you just a dry run. Most of the time you don't want to stretch these things up too much, or what I mean by too much is too, well, you don't want to stretch them three or four times. So it could be that I'm getting a other one to install on the car. So get yourself, I would advise you using silicone paste, but this of course will work just fine. So be sure, and because like I said before, we have to do the outside one, we don't have to, well, put it inside out. So then what you want to do is put it on there. Be sure that the end also is well, just like that. And then of course you shove it on there, and when you have it on there, then release the pressure. Of course this one is going to shoot out. And if it's on there, well, then you of course can do the rest. But you get the principle. You can do it without looping this thing up. It's of course easier to get it on the tool, but my experience is that then they will just rip or don't go back to the state they were before. But let's see how it works on the car. And the easiest way I think to get these off is, well, you could cut this, but most of the time just held it in place and just twist them. And they will snap just off. I do have a feeling that this one has been replaced before, but most of the time factories don't use these bands. And that's band number two. And as you can see, this is a different clamp. So I do think that, or it has popped off and they've put it back, or it has been replaced. But they use two types of, hardware. And if you're a regular viewer, you know that this is my least favorite job on the whole car. But get yourself a razor blade, because it's always messy. It is a messy job, this. What you now want is to clean up the old grease as good as you can. Just get your wife's pajamas and get it out of there. She will definitely adore the new design. Ow. Sometimes I will rinse it out with brake cleaner. And most of the time I do that when I do see some water in there. But in this case, I don't see it. And then I rather leave it alone. So we're getting our tool ready. It is looped up. Push this back as far as I can and hold it in place. And hopefully don't get my fingers destroyed. So it is on there. Now just slide it over here and release the pressure. And that's that. Of course, like I said, this thing is way too big. Let's see what size it has to be. Well, you know what I said, one size fits none. Of course, we could cut this off, but that's not what we're going to do. We're going to first put in the grease, then clean up the ridge and, well, the end of the boot that has sitting here on the ridge. Don't worry too much on getting it into the system, because first of all, it is not completely empty. And second of all, if you just drive it for a little bit, it will, well, get to it better than we can do it ourselves. But if you really want to do that, of course, be my guest. And maybe you're thinking, well, what a big mess to do it with one of these stretch things. And well, I cannot really argue with that. The only thing is, I do know people that are so damn handy with this thing. They don't even use grease or anything, but I'm not really that lucky. Maybe they have some other boots, of course. Well, these boots are definitely not cheap. They're from Speedon. For the people out there don't know Speedon, well, this is what they do. They make everything from complete axles to CV joints, custom-made stuff. I do also believe they make steering racks. Well, they know their stuff. Let's say that. Of course, these things are always way too big. So what I do is I just cut off the majority of it. Just be sure that you file the edges. And
I just crimped them a little bit. So it stays in place. And now what we want, of course, is that the bend is sitting on the ridge as good as it can, so it doesn't slip off. That happens a lot. Next up, of course, the backside. What I like to do is that push it all the way some that it isn't really extended, so it tries to pull itself off here. You want to have it on there. So both are on there. Now we can cut off the excess. Just get yourself a sharp blade and cut around it. So, and there you have it, how to change, in this case, on a Skoda Fabia, the CV joint boot with one of these things. Well, as you have seen, it is not the easiest thing to do. I still think that I can do it faster with removing the CV joint itself. But yeah, it has some convenience, and I definitely know if you do this more often, then yeah, this is going to be a lot faster. I thought this was a fun video just to use this thing. It just came to be. But yeah, that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, or at least learned something from it. And if you did, please give the like. If you want to follow me around, you know what to do. And I will see you next time. Bye. Yeah.